Good morning, everyone. Today, I will be presenting our recent study on technique for removing unnecessary superimposed pattern from image using generative network. This study is a part of our research on acquiring a depth map of the subject from the subject image captured by a normal RGB camera and embedding it in a subject image invisibly. The depth map is a two-dimensional distance information from the camera to the subject, as shown in the lower right in this slide. And it is a key information for 3D space content. There are various ways to obtain the depth map. The pattern projection method is one of the effective methods to obtain it. The pattern projection method is divided into two types: the projection of a visible pattern and the projection of an invisible infrared pattern. Visible patterns are used when only a depth map is needed, because the projection pattern appears as noise in a captured RGB image. An infrared pattern is used when a depth map and RGB images are both needed, because the projection pattern does not appear in RGB images. However, this method requires an infrared projector and infrared camera in addition to a normal RGB camera. Our research is for that. Our research is for this case, which requires both a depth map and an RGB image. However, we use a visible light pattern. We have been studying depth map acquisition technique that projects periodical pattern on the subject. When a periodic pattern such as line and space is projected onto the subject under certain condition, the depth map is obtained from the spatial frequency of the pattern in the image captured with a camera. The final goal of our study is to acquire a subject image that contains an invisible depth map of the subject. So after the depth map of the subject is acquired from the periodical pattern in the captured image, this pattern is removed from the captured image. And then the depth map is embedded in the captured image as invisible information. This final output image can be treated as a normal 2D image for transmission and storage, although it includes 3D information in the form of a depth map. And if necessary, we can read out the depth map and convert the 2D image into a 3D image. In this study, we focus on the technique that aims to remove this superimposed periodical pattern from the captured image. A conventional method uses transform to frequency space, like Fourier transform, to remove a specific frequency component. However, the texture which contains the same frequency component as that of the projected pattern hamper complete pattern removal. Since spatial frequency of the pattern on the subject, since spatial frequency of the pattern on the subject depends on the depth of the subject, it is unknown. And this also makes it difficult to completely remove it. And so we tried to remove it completely using a generative network called GAN. GAN is short for Generative Adversarial Network. For compiling, we also tried to remove the pattern with an autoencoder. Let's look at the experimental procedure that we use in our study. The experiment was conducted by simulation. This slide explains how to produce captured image of the subject on which periodical pattern are projected. Several images were used as subject, and this image is one example. First, we cropped 448 images of 256 by 256 pixels from the several subject images. We used the line space pattern as the periodical projection pattern. Assuming that this pattern is projected with blue light, the B channel image of the cropped image and the projection pattern image were multiplied to produce a captured image on which a Lyon space pattern was superimposed. Let's look closely at the projected pattern. We use Lyon space pattern with different amplitudes and spatial frequencies. Its average brightness was 200, and the amplitude was changed in 5 steps, of which the minimum was 10 and the maximum was 50. These values indicate the grayscale with the maximum of 255. These are magnified Lyon space, and these are magnified Lyon space pattern when the amplitude was 50 and 10. And the image on the right simulated captured images. Spatial frequency was changed in 16 steps from 0.18 to 0.25 lines per pixel. We generated 7,192 captured images from the combination of 448 subject images and 16 Lyon space patterns with different spatial frequencies. Of these, 5,600 were used for learning. 700 were used for evaluating in learning, and 700 were used for evaluation by PSNR, peak of signal to noise ratio, and SSIN structural similarity. This figure shows the configuration of the GAN used in our experiment. As you know, GAN consists of a generator and a discriminator, and the generator consists of an encoder and a decoder. An image containing a Lyon space pattern was input to the generator, and the generator output a projected image, which was expected to contain no Lyon space pattern. Two images were input to the discriminator as training data. And G-channel images on which no pattern was projected were input to the generator in addition to the P-channel images as differences. This is because there is a correlation between the G and the V-channel images, and this correlation was expected to enhance the prediction accuracy. The encoder and decoder of the generator consist of eight layers each, and the discriminator consists of six layers. These generators are convolution layers. The value indicate the number of nodes in each layer. N is changed from 1 to 32 as an experimental parameter. And these values, these numbers like 128 by 128 and 64 by 64 and so on, indicate the pixel size of the node of the middle layer. This figure shows a detailed configuration of the encoder. 4x4 kernel filters were used for convolution, and leaky red was used activation function. This video shows a detail of configuration of decoder. 4x4 kernel filter were used for convolution also in decoder, and red was used as an activation function. We use three dropout layers. This video shows the detailed configuration of the discriminator. Like the encoder, 4x4 filter and leaky red was used as a kernel and activation function. This video shows the configuration of the autoencoder used for comparison. The encoder and decoder consist of five convolution layers. This video shows a detailed configuration of the encoder and the autoencoder. A 3x3 kernel was used for convolution. Leaky red was used in the encoder as an activation function. This video shows a detailed configuration of the decoder of autoencoder. A 3x3 kernel was used also in the decoder, and then was used in the decoder as an activation function. Now, let me present the result of the experiment. This video shows an example of the input predicted and true image when using GAN. In this video, N is the number shown in previous slide, which is proportional to the number of nodes in the middle layer. As this video shows, we cannot see the line space pattern at all in all of predicted images. These are predictive images. and the predictive images look almost the same as the true images. This video shows an example of the predicted image when using autoencoder. We cannot see the line space. However, details of the image were not reproduced accurately compared to when using GAN. This video shows the PSNR of image after pattern removal using GAN and autoencoder. against the original images. Original images means the component image before the pattern was superimposed. This idea shows the dependence on the amplitude of the line space pattern. And the dashed line indicates the value before removing the pattern. It can be seen that the PSNR improved greatly, especially when the GAN was used. It exceeded 45, and this is high enough value for the purpose of this study. In this figure, the PSNR was obtained as a dependence on the amplitude of the line space pattern, and it is also seen that the PSNR decreased as the amplitude of the amplitude of the pattern increased. However, decrease was slight, considering the difference in amplitude of the line space pattern. This might be because the pattern is not complicated, so the GAN can be easily trained and output an image close to the true image, regardless of the amplitude of the line space. We can see that the PSNR for the GAN was higher than that for the autoencoder. Therefore, GAN is better than an autoencoder for our system. This video shows the dependence of the PSNR and SSIN when using GAN on the number of nodes of the middle layers. For this figure, it is seen that PSNR and SSIN increase as the number of nodes increased. However, even when n was 1, the PSNR exceeds 45, and SSIN was 0.099. Both are high enough for our system. This video shows the dependence of the PSNR when using GAN on the spatial frequency of the line space pattern. It shows that they are almost independent from the frequency and high enough at any frequency. Okay, in conclusion, we tried to remove the unnecessary line space pattern superimposed on the captured image using the generative network, GAN, and autoencoder. From the experimental, it was shown that these periodic patterns were effectively removed by using GAN and autoencoder to the point of being invisible. They also show that the performance of GAN is much higher than that of autoencoder, and its PSNR over 45. From the result, we demonstrate the effectiveness of the technique with GAN. That's all my presentation. Thank you for your attention.